In today's supercharged media environment, even modest families like the McDermotts of Middletown can find themselves caught up in the frenzy. We have a couple of examples to share from this past year. On a family vacation to Las Vegas, how we ended up in Vegas is another story. But Rita, Leah, and I decided to visit the home of one of our favorite cable TV shows, Pawn Stars. Well, we weren't in the store for 2 minutes before one of the show's producers asked to film us shopping. He handed Leah a cue stick, and here's what showed up on the History Network on December 5th. Of course, if you blinked, you missed it, so I'll show you again. Here's Leah with Rita looking on. And I was asked to try out a nice Harley. No problem there. In other media, the store where Rita works celebrated its 85th anniversary. News Channel 8 came to document the festivities and, as you're about to see, Rita was among the employees they featured.
The jewelry store in Middletown is marking a major milestone this month, but it's how they're celebrating that has a lot of people talking.
Tonight, News 8's Josh Scheinblum shows us what's being done.
It can be something special, and it can be something that's really fun.
When you purchase a piece of jewelry...
This is their other style earring.
Oh, okay.
You're buying something that will last.
But it looks like an old mine cut.
It's always a happy occasion.
Perhaps even something you can pass on.
It can be something that I would hand down to my daughters.
It's not food, shelter, or clothing. It's just something that humans have always migrated to.
At Maliv's Jewelers in Middletown...
So one size.
Yeah.
Owner Mark Levine says keeping jewelry in the family is central to their business model.
Back in 1928, my grandfather started as a gift store, and he had a package store and a market.
Things have changed a little since then.
The space will be a little bit bigger, but not that noticeable.
But this month, they're celebrating 85 years in business.
I love to deal with people. I love to give back to community. My father's taught me how to do that, and my grandfather taught my dad how to do that in a young age.
In looking back on how far they've come.
76. See, they paid $5.
Yep.
There's a balance due.
It's a lot different now. There's no credit cards back then.
As you might imagine, not everything at a jewelry store is inexpensive. Wow. But here at this shop, there are some things they are literally giving away for free.
There, how's that?
That's because they're donating to those in need.
I brought stuff I know they need, like shampoo and stuff like that.
Whenever we do a food drive or any type of community thing, how about we get a great response?
An 85th birthday party that's responding to the needs of customers.
Do you have the Giants in silver?
And all those in their community.
I just want them to have what I can have.
In Middletown, Josh Scheinblum, News 8.
Finally, Leah sent us a link to a commercial. These McDermotts have absolutely no connection to this commercial, except as stated up front. It's just a coincidence, although I'm sure we have some quirks of our own.
I didn't choose to be part of the McDermott family. They chose me. 34 Christmases now, and let me tell you, it hasn't all been sugar and spice.
Boys.
There were times I didn't think I'd survive. Like the year the kids found Dad's old bowling ball in the attic. Or when Aunt Ruthie burnt the yams. I'm telling you, I've seen it all. Even Uncle Luther and his fake snow. Sure, they're loud, and sometimes they're a little wild. But when the McDermotts get together to watch something on Netflix...
I'm not a smart man, but I know what love is.
I gotta say, it makes me smile. Then again, it's kind of painted on my face.
Netflix. It just might bring everyone together.
2013 was quite a year. And what does 2014 have in store? Only time will tell. Happy viewing!